his posing, his sweet bansi, everything is so sweet. If he walks very sweet, if he laughs very sweet, if he becomes angry, so sweet. If he is posturing anything, he is stealing butter and everything in house, oh, more sweet. He is killing to demons, oh, more sweet.
He is stealing hearts.
By all these things. So you should try to remember this song, not by singing. Then it will be more beautiful. Some pronunciation you should try to
improve.
I will tell where some is lacking, something lacking. I will tell you. And that's it will be very good. Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Itadaya Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tad Bhaktaya. Oh, you stop. You should not stop.
No.
He stop.
It should go on by rounding. Round. Otherwise it will be. Yesterday I was looking about Chaitanya Charitamrita, and at once the same page came where there was some dialogue between Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Pradyumna Mishra. You know Pradyumna Mishra? He was one of the brahmachari and very learned person. And he wanted to associate with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He may be kept as the associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. One day he came to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and told, Prabhu, I want to hear some Hari Katha from Krishna Katha, pastimes of Krishna. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, in natural way, he told, Mishra, I don't know any Harikatha. If really you want to hear a Harikatha, then you can go. To whom? I have heard and hearing still Hari Katha, Krishna Katha, very sweet. I don't know all these things like him. So better if you are going to him. Told that yes, I may go. And he went there at about 9 in morning. Or 8 in morning. At that time, Raya Ramananda was not his council. He was in his garden, in a very secret place. And he was doing something. So, Pradyumna Mishra told to his servant, who was in his council, that I want to meet Pradyumna Mishra.
Raya Ramananda.
Raya Ramananda. He honored so much to Pradyumna Mishra because he was in red cloth and brahmachari, monastic brahmachari. And he was so learned and Brahmin. Mishra means Brahmin. So India especially all has so much honor for Brahmins, and if Brahmachari, then what to speak of? So he told that you should wait. But he is now with some young ladies, teenage age, and they are called Devadasi. And he is teaching them Jagannath Ballabh Natak. He has wrote himself. He has composed this. Natak means?
Dance performance.
Drama book. About Jagannath. There are so many good songs, sweet songs, and it is very high class of Siddhanta in them. So Devdasi is training them how to dance before Jagannath. First, he is decorating them. He is giving bath. He is giving perfumes and so many things, rubbing here and there, dressing them, decorating them, making their braids, and as if he is a lady and doing. She is a lady and doing. That a lady teacher. So he was doing this, and he was giving training that what is called how, what is called bhav, what is kilkinchit bhav, what is mode tithe, all the modes which afterward was given in Ujjwal Neelmani, special things. When beautiful teeny girls of gopis used to see Krishna, in what mood they used to see, how they were worshipping Krishna, and how Krishna used to take their worships in return, and they then how, bhav means the first stage when Shuddha Sattva takes sprouted, first stage. If any lady, very tiny ages, she is quite innocent, he is not charmed by any boy, but first glance he saw any beautiful, qualified boy, like Krishna, then how she became charmed, and what at that time pose? How you will see, sometime some neck will be like turned, and eyes like the first sprout of prem, it is called bhav. And more than this, it is called bhav. Oh, very beautiful. So he is teaching them that if you will see Jagannath and you are begin to dance, at first you should see Krishna. Jagannath like Krishna, not like no or no like this. You should see that a very beautiful Nanda Nandan is there, and very beautiful playing on float, and also he has some greed to meet you. But you should pose that I don't like in this way. And try to charm more and more. So he is teaching. Quite a more tight power. Like Krishna is giving garland. I don't need. This way. But always charmed to Krishna. And Krishna is so attracted. So he was teaching them how to pose like this and dance. If anyone, that girl, gopi girl, has so much mood in inside, but outwardly she is angry by the poses of Krishna, oh, you should return. But he is telling by words, not by heart. So how she can pose this, that Krishna will be attracted more. There are so many words, we cannot express all this in general persons. Kilkinchit bhav. She will see Krishna and Krishna will, oh, I will not let you go. You should be here. And then she is weeping. She is so angry. But some tears are coming. Happy that Krishna is touching me and I am touching Krishna. I wish that he should do like this. But oh, don't touch me. And tears are coming, laughing also, smiling also. So many postures are coming there. And he was teaching them that you should pose like this. How to dance? He was. How to keep your hands and feet like this and that. So many more Shivati. And it became about 12. Now he decorated them and no vikar.
Transformation.
Vikar means?
Transformation.
Transformation of anything. Like she was any girl teacher. And he was decorating their breasts, hairs, cheeks, doing like this. Yes. And so many things. Oh, giving sindur here. Some ornaments here. Kajal in their eyes, how beautiful. He was doing with his own hands. And it became 12. Then he prepared so many things. He brought Jagannath Prasadam. And with his own hand he
served them.
Like they were worshipable of Raramananda. Like that. Like he was worshipping them. Because they were the most beloved of Jagannath Dev. They always
used to dance.
Sing in front of Jagannath Dev. So he was like Braj gopis or Vrindavan gopis. They went to serve there. They used to serve their husbands. Why? Because Siddham, Subal, Madhubangal, they were serving Krishna. And gopis used to serve their wives. Why? Because they were beloved of Krishna. So he was serving all these teeny two girls like this. And when his training was finished, then he gave so much preparation to them. And then he took off all his shingar he had done. And he gave a chariot to them. And he took himself, these girls, to their homes, residence. And then he... Up till now, Pradyumnish were waiting there. He heard at once from his servant that, oh, Pradyumna Mishra is waiting for you. So at once he went. and he begged apologies from that Brahmin. Doing pranam. Oh, you are waiting for me? Anyone could not tell me that you have come? I am so much ashamed. Please forgive me. What service I can do to you? He told that now it is time for dinner break, lunch, and you have not even taken anything. So, and for me also, I will have to go. I am waiting from 8, and waiting, but you are absorbed totally in that. So, I will see another day. And after that, he came from there. He went to his home, and after that, in evening, he went to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his council, where all were there, Rups, Sarup Damodar, Raya Ramananda, and all were there. Only Rup, at that day, Raya Ramananda was not there present, but all were there. Mahaprabhu told, have you gone to Raya Ramananda to hear Harikatha? He told, I went there, but today I have no time. He has no time. He was badly engaged in anything, so I could not hear. But I heard that he was decorating two very teeny girls, aged girls. And I heard that he was also decorating them, and also dressing them, and teaching them alone. And he was Brahmachari Pradyumna, Mishra. He knew all these things, that he has read Bhagavatam. In Bhagavatam it has been told, any person who wants to serve Krishna, he should not have any connection with, if he is Brahmachari or Sannyasi, they should have no connection with ladies. If mother is there, if sister is there, aunt is there, we should not be alone with, and we should not laugh and make. If he is doing, then it is better to die in fire, not to be associated with this. So he was some dog tears. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu knew this thing, that he has some doubt, and he does not want to go. Then Mahaprabhu told, you know Raya Ramananda? He is my teacher. He is so high class of Vaishnava, that I fear from ladies what to tell, speak of ladies. Even any wooden statue, I see and become attracted. Once I heard a song of any lady, and I became so attracted that I follow. But my Govinda, he saved me. If I have touched, then I have given my body to ocean. I would have jumped. But he is so transcendental, that even if she can see any naked, very beautiful lady, he can serve as he served yesterday. But no, nothing, vikar,
transformation in his body.
Transformation in his body. He is not made of these worldly things. He is so supreme, transcendental. What I know? I knew from Raya Ramananda. I know that he is not of this worldly sphere. So you can go. And he told so many things. Then he went again. And at that time he was in council, Raya Ramananda. Then Raya Ramananda did pranam to that Mishra, Pradyumna Mishra. what service I can render to you. Yesterday I have done some offense in your lotus feet. But now he has known from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and then he fell flat. Don't deceive me. Please tell some Harikatha. I have come here to hear some Harikatha. So I want to hear some Harikatha. Oh, you have remembered so many things. I am indebted to you. What kind of Harikatha you want to hear from me? He told that, I want to hear the same Harikatha that you
spoke to
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Oh, then he began from beginning. And from 8, it became 3 p.m. And he was so absorbed in hearing, and he was so absorbed in speaking, that where sun is going on? What is the time? Like Parikshit Maharaj and Sukadeva Goswami. So absorbed. Then knew nothing about day and night. Then he began to speak the glories of Krishna. And I was totally wondered, struck dumb.
Dumbstruck.
And hearing all these things, I've never heard in my any of my life. After that he told to me, at 3, a servant of Raya Ramananda Prabhu came. Prabhu, now it is 3 in evening.
Morning.
Sun is going to
set.
In west. So please be merciful to me, and Mahaprasad, Jagannath Mahaprasad is ready. You can both take. Then this Pradyumna Mishra told to Mahaprabhu, Prabhu, you should take. Then he gave to Prasadam to him. And both the two, they served Mahaprasadam. And he told to
Pradyumna
Mishra, don't think that I know all these things. I don't know ABCD of Rasa Tattva. What I have told? What it has come? It came from Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What he inspired in my heart? Only I tell, like Bansi. Bansi never tell anything. The Bansi, wala, how? Flute wala. You know flute wala? How he makes? He does like so. Like a puppet. A puppet wala makes them dance to do like this and that. Puppet will dance. Otherwise, puppets cannot dance. So how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu inspired me. And I am telling. So don't think that I am telling you all these katha. I am like a puppet. And don't tell these things to anyone. So now he has so much regard for him. And after that he went directly to Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he fell flat on Mahaprabhu. Oh, today I realized your mercy. I never realized before. But today I went to Raya Ramananda. And Raya Ramananda told so many things that he has told to you. And his heart was melting. Oh, Pradyumna Mishra. And he was weeping. Oh, you are so glorious. You are so kind and merciful that you sent anyhow to that person. I was not qualified to go there and to hear all these things. So you are certainly causeless, merciful. And Raramanand is more causeless, merciful. That he told me all these katha. My life is now successful. Up till now my life was not successful, but now my life is successful. To hear all these things. This is called association. I have come only to sprinkle these things of Raramanand Mahaprabhu and Rupa Goswami and others. But we are not so much qualified. So what I am telling, it is not mine, but inspired by Rupa Goswami, Raramanand Sarup Damodar, especially by the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Inspired by my all gurus, these things. So you should try to be like Pradyumna Mishra in second stage, after meeting Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You should go to any Vaishnava in same way. Very polite. And ask like ignorant person. In a very humble mode. Try to forget worldly things. Keep aside. Totally forget if you want to have all these things. Swamiji came to keep these things. But there was jungle of Mayavad and so many ignorances. So if there are jungles, how he can get all this sweet rasa? So he began to cut. And he wanted to make fertile our hearts. In some cases he did it. But most of his time went in this. He saw that very rare disciples are there. Very rare. To whom I can. So he wrote everything in his books. You can see there. But not everything. He kept something. If he was still alive in this world, he had written so and given so many things that now something I am giving. More than hundreds and lakhs times more than me. Because he was so much qualified. I am only like a dust, insignificance dust of his lotus feet. So, you should try to hear these things and follow these things. Don't say anyone's bad things. You should not discover anything bad from others. You should try to discover your bad things. And try to give up. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he used to come out of his cave, Gambhira, he used to show, oh, how beautiful Vrindavan this. To Chatak Parvat he used to see how? Oh, Girsaj Govardhan. And Bansi Bhat there is a Bhat banyan tree. Bansi Bhat. And sea, ocean, like Kalindi. And he used to see that, oh, so many persons are taking bath, oh, all gopis and gopis, Krishna is playing with them. So we should try to make our hearts like this. This is called bhajan, sadhan. Kriti sadhya, bhavita sadhya bhavasya, sadhana vidha, nitya siddhasya bhavasya, prakatanga. These are in our hearts, in transcendental heart, not in this body's heart. There are two kinds of heart. Two kinds of shape, two kinds of mind. Soul has its own body, mind, senses, intelligence, heart, everything. And how he serves, can serve Krishna. Everything like a seed in our heart. But if Shuddha Sattva from his associates will come in our heart, to whom he wants to follow, then it will sprout. Nitya siddhasya prakatang hridi shatyata. In seed everything is there. But it will sprout only by the help of air, light, and especially water. But what is there, only that will come. Like there are so many kinds of seeds, and one water is given, Ganges water is given, or they are all on the bank of Ganges. Same water is given to all, and same gardener is giving and serving and doing all of them. Same sun is giving light to them. But how they will come? All this seed will not give one tree or anything, same or different. So we are different here. But when this Shuddha Sat will come from Golok Vrindavan, from their associates like Siddham, Subal, Lalita, Vishakha, Rupmanjari and all, then by touching them, only that will come what is in your heart. In this world we see, oh, so many things are in earth. If there is no water, no this green herbs, green trees, green
vegetables,
flowers,
creepers,
and so many things we are seeing. Only due to rain and sun, these are prithvi. So all seeds are in earth, and all seeds have potency, their own, and same rain, same everything is coming on them, but different types of things, creepers, trees, animals, everything is coming. So like this, this jivatma soul has some his special kinds of seed, and in the special kind of potency is there. By the association of Vaishnava, that potency from Golok Vrindavan, from any of associates, will touch, and then it will come like nishtha, ruchi, asakti, bhav, prem, sneh, man, pranay, and so on. And what we are really, how we will serve Krishna, everything is here. So we should try to do bhajan like this, and to hear everything like Pradyumna Mishra or Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he heard from Swarup Damodar is more knowing, more. So if we will know these glories, then our heart will be charmed by this thing. We have come only to discuss all these things. So be qualified. Don't tell anything, your problems, that this has been done, this, and he's a bad man, he's good man, he's that, my wife has, all these problems will be. Surely this. But when bhakti will come, problems will be solved. There will be only problem. And that problem even in Srimati Radhika. That problem, she tells that, I have never seen Krishna. Never actually. I'm weeping, lamenting. I have not served Krishna. This is his problem. So this problem should come to us. Gaur Pramaya.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Krishna Krishna. Hare Hare.
I will have to go to take bath, and also I'm not feeling so well, so I'm going to take a rest. and also to take bath. So he should hear something from Gurukarma Prabhu. He is so qualified person, and he knows so many Harikatha more than me. And he can satisfy you, I can because my English is lame and my moods are also lame. But he has served his Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, and also
Pujyapad
Sridhar Maharaj, high class of Vaishnava.
And you, he's serving you. And because of that, he can say anything.
So you can hear, and I should go to take rest.
Gaur Premanande.
Srila Gurudev Ji. Jai.
Gaur Govinda Maharaj
Ji. Jai.
Bhakti Vedanta Swami
Maharaj.
You in morning, I was waiting from 9 to 12 to 11. But no Jagannath came. No need? But you should.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.